Hi, my name is Daryl Murray, and I work for the National Institutes of Health in the Office of Intramural Training and Education. I am the director of the Undergraduate Scholarship Program, or UGSP. In this brief video, I will share some important information about the Undergraduate Scholarship Program and address some frequently asked questions about the program. But first, I'd like to provide a little background. The NIH UGSP was authorized by Congress in 1994 through the Public Health Service Act and initiated by the NIH in 1996 when the program awarded its first cohort of UGSP scholars. Its goal was to award competitive scholarships to students from disadvantaged backgrounds who were committed to careers in health-related research in the biomedical, social, and behavioral sciences. The UGSP offers scholarships up to $20,000 per academic year, and the award is renewable up to 4 years. The scholarship can cover tuition and other reasonable educational expenses. In exchange for each year of scholarship support, selected UGSP scholars have two service obligations. The first obligation is a 10-week paid summer internship at the NIH main campus in Bethesda, Maryland. The second obligation is 1 year of full-time federal employment in a research group at an NIH Intramural Research Program campus. That's after graduation from your four-year university. The year-long obligation can be deferred to attend a qualifying educational program, such as graduate school or medical school. There are four main eligibility requirements for the UGSP. They are citizenship, enrollment status, your cumulative grade point average, and your exceptional financial need certification. Please visit our website to use the eligibility wizard to determine if you qualify for the first three elements. I will walk you through each of these and address some of the FAQs about them. First, citizenship. Because you will serve as a U.S. federal employee during your obligation, you must be a U.S. citizen or permanent resident. Next is your enrollment status. To qualify, you must be enrolled as a full-time student at an accredited four-year U.S. university, or you must be accepted as a full-time transfer student at an accredited four-year university at the time of your UGSP application. This could mean that you're transferring from one four-year university to another four-year university, or it could also mean that you are a community college student who is transferring to a four-year university. I would like to note that high school seniors are not eligible to apply. Third, grade point average. You must have a 3.3 GPA or higher on a scale of 4.0, or you must be in the top 5% of your class. Lastly is exceptional financial need, or EFN. EFN is defined by the federal government and it's based on low income thresholds that are published each year. You can find this information at our website. However, please note that assessing your income based on this table is not enough to determine your eligibility on your own. In the application, you will be asked to provide an email address for your financial aid office. An EFN form will be sent to the financial aid office at the email address you provided in the application. It will be your responsibility to follow up to ensure that we receive your EFN information by the mid-May deadline. Your financial aid office will not receive your request to send us your EFN information until you submit your application. The UGSP application opens in January and ends in March. We typically interview students in late June and make decisions about a new cohort by mid-July. The application has several elements that include a list of coursework and grades, a personal statement, resume information, and three letters of recommendation. I will cover each of these in the following slides. The online application will allow you to pace your coursework and grades. Include all of your collegiate coursework and grades. If you are a college freshman, include your high school grades too. If you are a transfer and community college student, please include your grades from your community college. Your personal statement should be succinct, but include pertinent information about your own unique journey and how your skills and experiences have prepared you to enter this program. You will have a general personal statement and also short essays that focus on what has led you to become passionate about health-related research. Here is where we'd like to know your ultimate goals and how you plan to reach them. You will also be required to complete a resume template. It will include contact information, extracurricular activities, awards, and accomplishments. You will fill out a template and not upload a document. This is a chance to demonstrate your interest in a research-related career. Perhaps it's a previous summer internship or school year research project, or participation in a science club, advanced coursework in a science, or a volunteer opportunity in a clinic. Tell us how your interest was manifest in and outside of the classroom. You will also be required to submit letters of recommendation. We're very aware of the importance of mentors in your career and professional development. One piece of advice I can give you is to identify individuals at your university that can share your goals and provide honest feedback about your progress. This could include a research advisor, a department chair, or a professor in your favorite course. It could be a postdoc in the lab that you worked in or a career counselor that you see. In any case, you want to ask if they can provide you a strong letter of recommendation. It would be helpful to provide them with your resume and description of our program. I'd like to add that you should never ask a family member to submit a letter of recommendation for you. Each year, we usually receive over 200 applications and accept between 15 and 20 applicants for each cohort. UGSP scholars have gone on to become really well accomplished in biomedical researchers and health-related professionals. To give you an idea of where our scholars are now, over 70% have received or are currently enrolled in programs for MDs, PhDs, and MD-PhDs, as well as master's programs and many other health-related professions. Our UGSP alumni are participating in medicine, completing clinical fellowships and residency programs. Some are also conducting research in academia, industry, and government, including right here at the NIH. I encourage you to visit our website to learn more about the program and the application process. Also explore other training opportunities at the NIH at www.training.nih.gov. We look forward to receiving your application. Feel free to email me directly at ugsp@nih.gov if you have any questions. Thank you for your attention and good luck applying.